The real Cowboys are on the picket line.
Same old song. I know every crack.
But inside this stadium today, the team they're calling here in the Texas Dallas area, the Rhinestone Cowboys.
The name of the game. And nice guys get washed away like the snow and the rain. There's been a load of compromising on the road to my horizon. But I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. Like a rhinestone cowboy. Riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy. Getting cards and letters from people I don't even know. And offers coming over the phone.
Well, there are the Rhinestone Cowboys, and of course the Cowboys staff hopes maybe they have a few diamonds in the rough. Their opponents today are from Philadelphia. And while these Rhinestone Cowboys have been embraced by the Dallas fans, that is not the case with these Ersatz Eagles. In a union town, they are the outcasts. But they're on the road today with a chance to prove that they can win a football game for Philadelphia. Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Ryan with Joe Theismann here at Irving Stadium. And the Cowboys are heavy favorites here today.
Humidity 62 and some light wind on the north, 13 miles per hour. It was a hot afternoon yesterday. Temperatures in the mid-80s. It's cooled off considerably. And I think for the Eagles and indeed for the young Rhinestone Cowboys, they'll be happy to have a little cooler weather. Now, you can see that the Eagles are one of the strong union teams. They have nobody in their lineup from the veterans. 18 have crossed the Dallas picket line. As we mentioned, 7 of them actually in the lineup today. There are several more who are on injured reserve back for treatment and so on. And as Joe explained, we'll be seeing Randy White, Ed Jones, Don Smirrett starting on defense. But we do not expect to see Dorsett, White, and Renfro starting on offense. Eagles receiving, and it's Kevin Bowman on his 4-yard line. Dropped out at the 27-yard line by number 58 linebacker Jeff Hurd of the Cowboys. Defending to our left, the green clad Eagles to our right. Scott Tinsley is the quarterback, a first-year man out of Southern California who started in last week's game against the Bears, was replaced by Guido Merkin. He'll face this rather intimidating defensive front. Jones, White, and Smirek with an enthusiastic youngster by the name of Mike Dwyer getting to play with the big boys today defensively for the Cowboys. First-year man out of Massachusetts. Had a big game last week. On first down, Reggie Brown, number 24. The second-year man from Oregon. And there is Mike Dwyer. And this kid gets himself ready to play the game. We had a chance to talk to him yesterday, and he is a pumped-up young man as he came out of the field today exhorting his defensive teammates to get serious here today. He is having plenty of fun. We'll be watching him throughout the course of the game. Mike Dwyer, free agent with the Bears a year ago, didn't stick. There's a loose ball at the 35-yard line. Looks like it's been covered by Dallas. It was Jacques Robinson who fumbled the football. Number 22, first-year man from the University of Washington. Former draft of the Buffalo Bills. And it looks like the Eagles have come up with a football.
Well, you know, Tim, that happens so often when you get in a wrestling match. What you find out is there you see the handoff. Now somebody's going to stick a hand in. You see Randy White knock the ball out from behind. The ball goes flying. Now there's a pileup. In the game today, they allow the players, you won't see the referees jump in right now, they allow them to wrestle around a little bit, try and pull the ball away. I can't tell you how many times I've been on the bottom of a pile, had the ball pulled away from me, and wound up going to the other team because I wasn't strong enough.
Well, Reggie Brown was the man to keep possession for the Eagles, a second-year man from Oregon, drafted by Atlanta back in 1982, and a USFL veteran, but looks like we may be looking at a replay upstairs with replay official Mark Burns.
There you see White knock the ball loose. Now it'll go forward. Now, this is probably the angle they're going to have to look at. But, see, that player's really not on the ball. To be truthful, it looks a bit inconclusive.
On further review, Philadelphia recovered the ball. Third down.
Well, when they looked at the replay, and there's a look at the boot, Mark Burns saw that ball evidently squirting under the Cowboy and grabbed by Reggie Brown of the Eagles. So Philadelphia now has third and two at their own 35-yard line. Scott Kinsley, number 11 from USC, the sales rep for a title insurance company, but he's not playing replacement football. Brown, first down, Eagles to the 46-yard line. Anthony Coleman made the stop, number 41.
Well, you know, when you get a lot of misdirection football, there you'll see Kinsley make the fake off to the back. Now Brown's going to come back to the left with the guards pulling. Nice hold, does a nice job of cutting. Now Randy White gets caught out of position. He makes the cut up the field and picks up the additional yardage. I'm sure that the fans looking at this Eagle football team don't recognize what happened between this week and last week.
Short drop from Kinsley. He's got a man open, but it's incomplete. Intended for Otis Grant, one of only two players to get a favorable mention from Buddy Ryan, head coach of the Eagles last week. Let's look at the rest of the Dallas defense. The linebackers are Dale Jones, Russ Swan, and Chris Dulabon. And the secondary, Jimmy Armstrong and Robert Williams on the corners. Tommy Haynes, who had a good week last week against the Jets at strong safety, and free safety Alex Green. Scott Kinsley brings out the Eagles. Ciano in motion. It's Brown again. This time he stopped right at the line of scrimmage. White got a piece of him, but it was Mike Dwyer who made the initial solid hit, number 71.
There's Mike Dwyer right in the middle of your screen. He just makes a lot of penetration. He takes on the center, just fights, keeps himself low, and then fights everybody off. He's a fine-looking football player. And he gets just a little excited.
Well, you know, he's fearful that he's going to be labeled a Gastineau type. He doesn't want that. He says, I just play with a lot of emotion. And he said, this is the most exciting time of my life. Kid is having a ball. Well, Kinsley opts for a timeout here on third down. And he was going to be running out of time on the 32nd clock. So evidently a little mix-up in getting the play in, the signals, etc. And week two of the replacement league, I guess you have to expect those kind of miscues.
Well, I after watching last week's games, I would even have expected it a little bit more. You know, it's difficult to get a play in. If you miss one sentence in the huddle, you have to restart the whole process, and all of a sudden you lose those 30-second clocks. Now, they're also in a situation here where the fans are being rather noisy. The Eagles go into a shotgun offense. That means that the communication from the quarterback to the center is going to be over a 5-yard area instead of only a 1-yard area. So that creates a problem as well. Ernie Staudner, there you saw in the big blue outfit. Many years I've had an opportunity to match wits with Ernie. Many years I've lost.
He's talking to Tommy Haynes, who's one of the more experienced members of the secondary of the Rhinestone Cowboys.
Scott Kinsley coming back after talking to Ted Plum. I had a chance to visit with Ted on the field. I said, what's this like? He said, it's a nightmare.
Yeah,
so best way to describe it. This isn't something you dream of. This is something you dread when you go to sleep.
Now, Buddy Ryan effectively acknowledging that the Eagles caught with their football pants down somewhat, along with, he reckoned, the Vikings and the Giants, and not being really ready to play strike football. And there has been some consideration that maybe a little of inside intelligence might have helped some of the teams prepare a little better. But nonetheless, they all knew what they were up against coming into this season, the strike possibility. Third down and 9. Shotgun, Kinsley. Incomplete. Out the sideline, intended for tight end Jay Repko, first-year man from that football power Ursinus College.
How'd they do yesterday? Do you know?
Repko played in the USFL. I'm not sure whether he had any other Ursinus teammates with him there or not. Fourth down, and the Eagles will have the punt.
This is where it gets exciting for the Philadelphia Eagles.
It did last week. Dave Jacobs, good punt. Or good snap, rather. Fair punt. Out of bounds at the 34-yard line, but a flag down at the line of scrimmage on the punting play. Dave Jacobs, a well-traveled punter around the NFL. 15-yard punt from Jacob.
Ineligible player number 52 on Philadelphia was downfield illegally. Penalty was declined. First down, Dallas.
Jim Tunney explains that infraction. The Cowboys will have it first down at their 37-1. And at Joe Theismann at Texas Stadium, the Cowboys will have their first offensive opportunity at their own 38-yard line. The quarterback is Kevin Sweeney, and he'll face this defensive front: Ray Phillips, Marvin Ayers, Randall Mitchell, and Elo Grooms. Fred Smalls, Byron Lee, and Dave Brown are the linebackers. And the secondary of Victor Bellamy and Angelo James on the corners. Troy West and Jeff Griffin arrived on Thursday in the Philadelphia camp and became an instant starter, mainly because he has 5 years of NFL experience. Reverse on the first down for the Cowboys, number 87, Kelvin Edwards. Touchdown. Up the rhinestone cowboy for Kelvin Edwards from Liberty Baptist College, cut from the New Orleans Saints after being drafted a year ago, number 4, dropped this year during training camp, found a home in strike football in Dallas, had 2 touchdown catches last week in the victory over the Jets, and on first down goes 62 yards for the score. Point after try by Luis Zendejas, and the Cowboys take a 7-0 lead over the visiting Eagles here at Texas Stadium. An enthusiastic crowd of 40,000 plus applauding the effort of Kelvin Edwards.
There you see the lineup. Now Kelvin Edwards is going to be out on the right hand, actually left hand side of your screen. As you see, they're going to line up. Now the Cowboys are going to shift. Also, the Eagles are going to shift. And as they move out, you'll see a little bit of the confusion that's created by the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, what happens when you have a bunch of guys that have just been put together in a short period of time, they lose their pursuit angles. As soon as the ball goes, you see Edwards go out in motion. Now, he'll stop and come back around as they go. Now, all the Eagles have pursuit. Very aggressive football team anyway. And now the wall is set up. He gets blocks from everybody. There you see Sweeney even trying to throw one. Now he's not going to be able to outrun anybody. And there he goes around the corner. There you see, come in motion now. Stops, turns around. Here comes the handoff, and he's on his way.
A great opening play for the Dallas Cowboys. And Joe, you make the point that the Eagles have an aggressive defense under Buddy Ryan. They have a swarming style. He said he was going to go with that today, even though these youngsters are not at all sophisticated in the use of the famous Buddy Ryan 46 defense. They were going to be coming all day, and the Cowboys thought they might catch them napping, and they did. Kevin Bowman takes the kickoff in the end zone. He'll not bring it out. And there is Buddy Ryan, and gets caught with a reverse play on the first Dallas offensive maneuver of the afternoon. Tampa Bay on top of San Diego in the first period. John Reeves, veteran quarterback, passing to Eric Streeter for the score.
That's back from an era when I played.
John Reeves.
Yeah.
First down, Philadelphia from their 20-yard line.
The Eagles really have to guard against a blowout early in this football game. If they can just get some kind of confidence, some kind of belief that they can move the football, at least they'll fare a little bit better.
They fake a reverse on first down, and Reggie Brown gets about 5 to the third 25-yard line. Jimmy Armstrong, the quarterback, number 35 from Appalachian State, knocks him out of bounds. Reggie Brown, a second-year man from Oregon, was drafted back in 82 by the Atlanta Falcons. He's 5'11", 211 pounds, and is a refugee from the USFL. Bowman comes out. Mike Ciano goes in at wide receiver. Picks up in the backfield, and Tinsley has to just fall down on the football. A collision with a running back. Loss of a yard on the play. Jock Robinson was the intended receiver of the handoff. Reggie Brown and Robinson, the running backs. Otis Grant, a former Ram receiver. Kevin Bowman, the starter on the right side. And Eric Bailey, the tight end. Third down and five. In the shotgun now, Tinsley. Deep sideline, complete. Grant, first down Eagles at the 44-yard line of Philadelphia.
There's Tinsley in the shotgun. It's just a nice job of protection. The premium today is going to be protection on the quarterback by that offensive line of the Eagles. You see Smerikit run out. Now he just wings it out to the sideline. Runs a nice deep route, winds up with a big completion. You know, Buddy Ryan, when he talks about his football players, he doesn't even know his regular players too much by their names. He refers to them as numbers, and he said, that number 81 is pretty good.
Yes, Grant and safety Troy West got two goals last week. Brown is dropped by Mike Dwyer, the youngster from Massachusetts, and then buried by Russ Swan, the linebacker number 57. And before the game, Joe Theismann talked to this enthusiastic young Mike Dwyer down on the field about playing alongside White, Smirik, and Tutal.
It's more of a result type thing, you know, effect type thing. If something happens out there that tends to fire me up, I shoot my mouth off about it, you know. I don't plan anything, it just comes natural to me, you know. So who knows what I'll be saying out there today.
It is second down and 15, and it's incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Jay Repko. And that'll leave third down. Well, Mike Dwyer admitted to us that he's kind of gabby out there, Joe.
He's a conversationalist. You know, if the situation gets rolling in the Cowboys' favor, he just starts to point at the offensive lineman and say, you've got four downs, you've got four downs, now you've got three downs. And he just tries to bait him on and bait him on. Fitting in with Randy and Don, he says he doesn't want to get too loud, but he can't let his emotions as a young man go away from him either.
Third down, inside pitch out, but whistles all over the place. It was Alvin Ross, number 41, the ball carrier, the receiver of that little shuffle pass.
False start, right guard, 5 yards. Still third down.
5 yard penalty against the Eagles for a false start, and the right guard is Scott Leggett, number 75, from Central State, Oklahoma.
You see him on the right of your screen start to go the wrong way. Actually, the right way for the shuffle pass, but he started too soon, so it became the wrong way.
So it is third down now back at the 35-yard line and a 20-yard need on the part of the Eagles here. Dallas leading 7-0 early here in the first period at Texas Stadium, and they've got seven men on the line of scrimmage on third down. Tinsley, however, gets some time now, runs out of it. Randy White takes him down at the 25. Well, now let's go for an update on the strike situation from Brent Musburger.
Vern, just a quick update, and Tim Ryan in Dallas, too. CBS Sports has just learned that the strike talks between Jack Donlin and Gene Upshaw will break off. A formal announcement is expected in about half an hour, and of course we'll have full details at halftime. The strike talks are over for now. Let's go back to the game.
At the 15-yard line, knocked out of bounds at about the 13, so the punting problems of the Eagles replacement team continue. Bruce Livingston, the man to block it.
There you see him coming from the outside. You see the players lined up here. What he's going to do is he's just going to come across, put the money on it, and it's gone. Here comes the, and as Tim mentioned, the punting problems have just been a nightmare for the Eagles. He just lays out in front of the ball, gets a hand on it. Now probably the biggest regret for the Cowboys is that they couldn't field this thing and get it into the end zone. That's what their disappointment was.
But they have first down inside the 15 of the Eagles. And the give is to Alvin Blunt. Blunt gets inside the 10-yard line. Rookie from Maryland. He was drafted this year by the Cowboys, number 9, but did not make it through camp, but one of the first guys that they call back for the strike situation. Last week against the Jets, he had 72 yards, and he's running in a spot normally occupied by number 33, Tony Dorsett.
You know, the biggest thing about this football game is the experience of the players having been in camp. and really the coaching of the special teams. That's where the real difference is going to lie. Offense and defense, yes, is a little bit of an imbalance, but in the special teams where you can really teach technique.
Second and five. It's once again.
Yard touchdown run for Alvin Blunt, and the Cowboys open the lead.
This one's going to come right after you see a little misdirection. There's Blunt to the right of the referee. He starts a little misdirection again. The Eagles overplay it and cuts up and is going to run right into your living room.
Luis Zendejas for the point after, and he's got it. The Cowboys, with 9:51 still to play, first period, lead at 14-0. Got a flag on the point after play.
Was defense. Point
against
was counted.
Philadelphia.
Penalized on the kickoff. 5 yards.
Referee Jim Tunney with the call, and we'll be right back at Texas Stadium. Kevin Bowman, and that's a good kickoff right through the end zone for Luis Zendejas. Five Zendejas brothers are kickers. His brother Tony kicks for the Houston Oilers, regular version thereof, or maybe soon to be Jacksonville Oilers or whatever. Sounds like they're seriously talking about leaving Texas for warmer climes or financially more secure climes. First down, 20-yard line. Philadelphia down 14-0.
They need to run three or more just good plays. What I mean by good plays is ones where people block like that, or you don't have any miscue by the quarterback, the back's not going in the wrong directions. They've got to gain some kind of confidence on offense.
Jock Robinson, number 22, the ball carrier, picked up five. Randy White and Russ Swan made the tackle for the Cowboys. Remember, the Cowboys with White, Smirik, and Ed Jones, three of their veteran starters on the defensive line. The Eagles have none of their veterans in uniform. Kinsley, quick pass for Brown, and that's a good play for a first down to the 39-yard line. Perfectly timed, little delay to the running back, Reggie Brown from Oregon.
You're going to see Reggie Brown just swing right out of here. The Cowboys bring everybody on a blitz. They're just bringing everybody in. Kinsley's going to drop back and just loop it right over the defense's head. And it's an excellent throw, an excellent execution. You see everybody clear the middle. Now he just hangs the ball up.
Chris Dulabon and Tommy Haynes made the stop, but it's first down. Eagles at their own 39. That is Brown again. He got only about a yard. Wire and White, the tackles on the hit, and the linebacker number 52 coming up into it, Dulabon. Dulabon was a 12th round choice of the Cowboys last year, was on injured reserve, released this year, brought back for the strike team.
This is like a JV varsity scrimmage.
Well, you know, it's interesting listening to Tom Landry. He refers to when the pros all come back.
Yeah.
As though these guys are semi-pros. He might be right. Reggie Brown, nowhere to go. It'll leave third and eight.
There's a guy out on the field who has probably the biggest challenge of the day. There's Randy White, and here's Pete Walters. Now, he's going to try and do whatever he can. He's got a series of different moves to work on, Randy, and let's see how this one goes for the first time. There's one. He sort of takes him on a little bit, rides him out. It's all right. I think you ought to keep that one.
I'd say keep that one in the inventory.
That's a keeper. Keep that one until he figures it out.
Pete Walters
defeats it.
Played his college ball at Western Kentucky. Very thoughtful young man, very bright young guy. Kinsley, short for Otis Grant. Flags down, I believe, unless that's some other debris, a towel or something. Now, evidently, it's a towel from one of the players, so it will be fourth down, Eagles.
Hold on to your hats.
There's Pete Walters. Walters' last football was in 1981, a shot with the Atlanta Falcons.
Now, what would you bet the Cowboys decide to come after this again, having had a little bit of success?
Jacobs gets a beauty away. That's a fine kick back to the 15-yard line. Cornell Burbage
gets it out to the 23. Well, Jacobs certainly made up for his 15-yarder. 7:14 to play. First quarter, Dallas on top.
This is Guido Merkins. Now, here's Fred Smalls. He's supposed to come out and block. As Coleman comes around, he quits right here, or else he might add a shot at that one. You see him stop right there.
We're back live, and a flag down on first down for the Cowboys at Alvin Blunt. That may be a yard. Look to me on your diagram there on the telestrator that Merkins, the up back, was maybe a little too far up. He wasn't at much of an angle to help out.
Well, you have to understand, last week, the up back of the Eagles blocked a kick, and he had the ball kicked into his butt. So, and they even spelled his name right this week. See, that means that this, you're in week two. That's how you can tell you're in week two. It was an I instead of an E. There was M-E-R-K-I-N-S last week. So, I mean, that's when you know you're starting to settle in, when the uniform people get your name right.
Mike Renfro is into the ball game for the first time today. The Dallas veteran receiver, number 82, and he is in motion. First and 15. That's Blunt again. And Blunt gets about three back before Fred Smalls makes the tackle. Smalls, a draft choice of the San Diego Chargers last year, and then played in the CFL earlier this season. Played on top of Green Bay. There's one of the few veteran players on the Eagles team you saw there, Paul Reisick.
Yeah, I played with Paul's brother, Dan, with the Redskins. He was a center, special team snapper. You know, talking to Tom Landry, he said, the most important guy on this football team is not necessarily the quarterback, it's the centers on the special team, making sure they get the punts, get
the ball back.
Yeah.
Right. Second and 11 for the Cowboys. Sweeney, that's complete. It's Burbage, and Burbage breaks loose. He'll score. Burbage, 77-yard touchdown pass play from Kevin Sweeney, and a rookie from Kentucky who was in the regular camp, brought back as a strike replacement player, and has himself another Cowboy touchdown. He scored last week against the Jets, and he has Dallas on top with this point after by Zendejas, 21-0. And we still have 6:20 to go in the first period.
Happy young man. You'll see it now. He's going to go right back into the pocket. Sweeney's going to get back set up and just fire this thing on a line out here to Burbage. He's going to break a bunch of tackles, and it's going to be a TD. Good protection again by the offensive line of the Cowboys. Now, he just rockets this thing. Now, this is a great piece of running. Bellamy has a shot at him. Jeff Griffin, who just signed with the ball club on Wednesday, had a shot at him. And nobody's going to catch him. This is really, I think, the difference between a team that's been together and one that hasn't. Here you see Kevin Sweeney go back in the pocket. Now, Burbage is working on Bellamy. He just makes a turn in and then just outruns everybody. Does an excellent job of keeping on his feet. And off they go.
Well, you know, the game we had last week, Washington-St. Louis, was a fairly well-played game, all things considered.
All the way around, right.
Reminded me a lot of the old, early days of the American Football League, and where you see these big passing plays where once a receiver gets the ball, and the quality of the secondary isn't there.
They've had the ball for three possessions. They've scored three touchdowns. They remind me a little bit of what the Sooners did yesterday in that city for the Longhorns of Texas in the second half. This is Cornell Burbage. 77 yards, it's 21-0, Cowboys over the Eagles.
Short drop by Tinsley, and the pass complete off the right side to Mike Cieno. First-year man from Syracuse. Picked up about 4 yards on the pass play.
One of the problems you're faced with when you throw to the right against the Cowboys is this guy right here, Ed Jones. If you throw a short step and try and throw it around him, it's going to cause the ball to come back over this way. Tinsley just set 1-2-3. Now Ed Jones gets those arms up. You see that arm come up, and you see where the delivery of the ball is so far behind the receiver. That's the kind of a presence problem he causes on the field.
6'9", and it sounded to me as though you remember that situation. Oh, he's been knocking down all the time. Reggie Brown Picks up about four more, and he's tripped up by Mike Dwyer, the rookie from Massachusetts. Last week, Dwyer with a sack and eight tackles in the winning effort against the Jets. Reggie Brown, for his part, had 34 yards and 11 carries against the Bears. Third down and a long yard. Robinson is out. Alvin Ross is in the Eagles' backfield. Short yard. Tight end in motion. Lot. First down, Eagles, to the Cowboys' 32-yard line. Jimmy Armstrong tripped him up.
Eagles are starting to put something together. You know, that's the thing that you have to do, is put some positive plays together. You can't look at the scoreboard. Gosh forbid if you ever glance up, but you can't look at a scoreboard in this situation. You just got to keep on plugging along.
Hensley for Grant, and interference will be called on the Cowboys. Robert Williams, number 23, who bothered Grant all the way down to the goal line. So the Eagles will have a first down. It looks like it'll be near the 10-yard line. Here's Jim Tunney.
Pass interference. Defense, number 23, first down.
Right on the left side of your screen. It's not in the picture now, but it will be in a second. You'll see the contact. Now, you just can't lean on people. Each player has access to the ball, but you have to give a guy a chance. That's an excellent call, a tough call, I think, by the referee when both players are fighting for it.
Well, but we saw, if we had seen a little more on the replay, he had really been pushing and jostling with him there.
All the way down.
Prior to it, yeah. First down, Eagles. They need to get to the one for a first. And the pass out the right side intended for the tight end, Jay Repko, and that's incomplete. Second down. Scott Tinsley has his wife, Debbie, and his three-month-old daughter, Kayleen Rose, here today, as they came over from California, where Tinsley now lives, but he's originally an Oklahoma man.
And, you know, that's tough for a guy. Here he is in a motel. He's got to live in a motel on a day-to-day basis. He's away from his little baby. He's away from his wife. I think that's one of the things people don't realize about these replacement players. They're sequestered away, you know, a motel room somewhere, waiting to find out if they're working tomorrow.
Tinsley gets time, now running out of it, and Randy White drops him behind the line of scrimmage. Good coverage by the Cowboys in the end zone. And that gave White the opportunity to make the sack. Actually, the Eagles had pretty good protection there at the line of scrimmage.
They did. That's one I think he could have thrown the ball away. Try and save the sack a little bit. Plus, not only is it a loss of yardage, but it's a mental thing for the players. It's a, you know, your offensive line. Last week they give up 11 sacks, or 12 sacks last week, I think. Cowboys sacked the quarterbacks 11 times. It's a psychological thing more than any for their offensive linemen.
Third down and two out of the shotgun, Tinsley. And he drops again. It is Randy Watts, a rookie from Catawba. Randy Watts, ninth round choice of the Chiefs.
You'll see Watts right out here. That's Randy White, and this is the pressure they're going to put up the middle. This back's got to come in and help out. That means that tackle is one-on-one, Jeff Wentzel. And that's a tough chore, I think, for any lineman. You see the back have to help out. Wenzel gets caught inside in Sac City.
Field goal try 40 yards away for Jacobs, and he has it. So the Eagles get on the board with a 40-yard field goal by Dave Jacobs. And the score stands 21-3 Dallas. And Joe Theismann with Critteroo, the armadillo, a special guest mascot here today.
That's a tech.
That is David Adams returning the Eagles kickoff to the 32-yard line. David Adams, a 5'6", 170-pounder from Arizona. Well, there's the well-dressed Tom Landry, hat and all, indoors or out. And wears a necktie. He is he's a very careful and elegant dresser.
How many guys wear neckties?
Among the coaches?
Yeah.
Well, Ditka is wearing a necktie now, and we see Ron Meyer and Dan Reeves and Ray Perkins. Last week, the neckties had four victories to only one loss, and the less well-dressed went 10-13. See, we bring you all of the pertinent facts during replacement football. Kevin Sweeney. And it is incomplete. Second down. Let's take this opportunity to get a sense of what else is going on around this second week of replacement ball. Let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Well, let us interrupt this game briefly and send you for a look up to Soldier Field in Chicago. The Viking replacement team showing some improvement today, and they are holding the Bears scoreless. The Bears were a 20-point underdog in that game.
With a 49-yard attempt. And that is wide left. Had enough foot, but he's off target left, and so the score remains. The Cowboys 21 and the Eagles 3. In that first quarter, Dallas had 94 yards rushing to only 37 for the Eagles. And the Cowboys had 99 yards passing with one touchdown strike from Sweeney to Burbage from 77 yards. And 59 yards passing for the Philadelphia Eagles. And you can see that veteran Dallas defense coming up with the three sacks of the Eagles quarterback Scott Tinsley in the first period. And Philadelphia, with their game last week, 35-3 defeat at the hands of the Bears, they have been looking up at large numbers against them on the scoreboard. This is Alvin Ross, and nowhere to go for Ross trying to turn the corner out the left side.
You know, the most difficult thing to do, I think, in coaching these players is getting them in the right place. When you've got replacement players on the field, you have to direct them to certain areas of the field, certain gaps to cover. That's the big advantage that the Cowboys have, is their players know where to go. Smerick knows where to go. White knows where to go. Jones knows where to go. And all the other guys that have played up front. I don't think the Eagles are going to be able to run the football at all this afternoon. They're going to have to move it if they're going to in the air.
Brown gets two good blocks, and Brown looks like he has the first down over the 40-yard line, depending on the spot, and finally dropped by Jimmy Armstrong, a cornerback from Appalachian State.
You know, I haven't played against the Cowboys as many years as I did for 12 years in the National Football League. What happens is the place to throw the ball against them is little screen passes like that, in routes, turn-ins, 12, 11, 13 yards down the field. That's where they're most vulnerable, and probably the most undisciplined part of their defense would be the drops of the linebackers. So if I'm going to put the ball up, those would be the areas I would attack if I was Eagles. It's, you know, it doesn't look good, but they could make it.
How about a pass play right here, third and a foot, your own 40?
Absolutely. Or let the quarterback sneak it and get stuck.
There's an idea, and if you don't make it, then you have to punt.
I would go for it. What's Buddy got to lose? Go for it on fourth down. I mean, you know, you're 18 points down. You're only started the second quarter. I gamble. You're on the 40-yard line.
Well, they're going to bring in the chains with the spot. They might wind up with the first down, but from our angle here, it looks like they're going to be just short.
Well, you know, the referees have had big feet today. You know, the spots have been a little giving this afternoon. Jim Tunney's like that. He's a nice guy, takes care of the players, always used to talk to me in the huddle, ask how I was doing, if he could help me or anything.
Did you reply? I mean, that's
absolutely
quite an opportunity.
I said, where do you want me to start? You got to go
short.
For it. Sure, you got to go for it. You can't punt it. First of all, consider what's happened in your punting game.
Yeah, that's right.
If you're the Eagles. I mean, you know, three touchdowns have been the result of the kicking game in five quarters of football. So you figure, why not? Go for it. Good call, Buddy.
Jones, Randy White, Don Smerick, and Mike Dwyer. Mike Drew, well, he's fitting in there very nicely. They may not have made it. It's going to be again dependent on the spot.
No, I think he did. Like I said, the officials have been very big-footed this afternoon. There's Ted Plum trying to get out and express his feelings.
Howard Rowe, the line judge, number 33, making the spot.
Ernie Stotner, there he is.
And I'm sure we stopped him.
Of all the coaches, he's got probably the best situation because he's got three out of four of his linemen in.
See, yeah, first down, Eagles. Cool.
You see that? You see, replacement players, any player knows you don't step in front of a camera when it's shooting a short measurement. that he's got right now. That's just it's an uncharacteristic replacement player mistake.
I don't agree. I'd say this kid is very sophisticated. He knows where the cameras are and gets himself on.
Yeah, but don't put your back to it.
First down, Eagle. Hindley, short drop, complete on the left side to Grant. First down, and Grant fights. Not first down, pardon me, about a 6-yard gain. And it is Robert Williams, the cornerback number 23, making the tackle for the Cowboys.
Those are not the kind of possessions that, you know, you want to start. Your field position isn't that bad, but 6 plays and a punt, 6 plays and a block punt, 5 plays, well, 2 out of 3, you got the ball up, and a field goal. So, I mean, they're getting the ball up the field, they're moving it, but they're just making too many mistakes in the special team area.
Okay. Second and 6 for Tennessee here. Up front, now going deep.
He got him.
And it is complete to Cieno. First down, Eagles. At the Cowboys' 21-yard line on the coverage, Jimmy Armstrong, number 35.
Well, this is just a simple out and up. You saw the Cowboys do it. He's on the right part of your screen. You'll see Tinsley come back in the huddle. Now he'll make a pump fake to the outside. There's the pump. Now just hang it up. Each offense is taking advantage of the aggressiveness of the defense. You know, guys will try and cut off interceptions, so they run outs and ups. These are the kind of things we run on the, you know, sidelines, and when you get a good junior varsity football team, that's the kind of stuff you want to use. Reverses, outs and ups.
Timeout on the field, and we'll be back with Dallas on top. Bill Theismann at Texas Stadium, the Cowboys on top 21-3. And they...
They got blown out by the Bears in that one.
Elo Grooms made a good point about the heat. He said, you know, my kids are on this team, we're all excited about how nice the weather is when they got here in Dallas. So we don't want it hot. Fortunately, it turned out a little cooler today.
Yes, it did.
Reggie Brown stopped at the line of scrimmage. Wire and White, the 2 tackles. And again, a pumped up Mike Wire.
You know,
he's having... an awful good
he's
time
just
out
real
there.
He's just real excitable. There he is right there. He's just going to come in and just mess that whole thing up right in the middle. He goes up against Scott Leggett. Now he fires in. Leggett gets down on him. Dwyer just sticks his arm and shoulder right in. He's playing like, there he is.
Well, you startled him yesterday when you handed him the Dallas Cowboy program with his picture on the cover from last week against the Jets and asked for his autograph.
Sure, I got it, you know. You never know.
He loved that. Tinsley just flips it off for Brown, and that is incomplete. Little push pass. Flag down on the play, off the ball. And the Eagles could get lucky here with interference on a player who was away from the ball.
Now, you see, that was a running play. That's an ineligible man downfield. You have to understand, that was that little shovel pass that they ran before and didn't get anything out of. What happens is it's treated like a running play. So the linemen block quick at the line of scrimmage, you get the ball off. What happens is Tinsley had to hold the ball longer, therefore the lineman went downfield and he threw the ball and it became a pass. So that's what this ruling is going to be. Ernie says, don't take it. Refuse it.
Ineligible player, number 68, downfield illegally. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
That was Pete Walters playing the run as Joe just described it, and gets caught because the play developed into a pass play. So it is fourth down. And the ball is at the 21-yard line of Dallas.
You know, that's one of those plays where it's an underhand shovel-type pass, which is treated by the offense like a running play, but yet if the ball goes on the ground, it's considered an offensive pass. So, you know, you call it a pass, you call it a run, whatever you want.
Dave Jacobs from the 29-yard line, the 28, making a 38-yard try, and it is no good. Jacobs with 1 field goal to his credit from 40 yards away, misses on this try. And gets up a little slowly. And he is their only punter and kicker in the lineup.
Here he's going to, the ball gets down. Now, to me, this is one of the most vulnerable situations anybody can be in. You see his foot planted. Now, watch the Cowboy come flying along. You know, they say the guys get blocked into him and everything, but it's, I would imagine that they're going to sit down and have some meetings about that next year and figure out how to protect the kickers a little bit. Last week he made a tackle on a kickoff, got dinged, and wound up walking a little bit later on in the quarter over to the Bears bench after he made a field goal.
First down, Cowboys with a 21-3 lead here in the second period. Kevin Sweeney, the quarterback. That is Alvin Blunt. We have yet to see Tony Dorsett if you joined us along the way, and it may well be that we don't see him at all. A flag down on that last play. Matt Battaglia and Fred Smalls made the tackle for the Eagles.
There's, you can see Tony Dorsett. Landry behind, he's hiding.
He doesn't, you know,
stay out of it. He talked about
offside, lining up in the neutral zone, number 51, 5 yards, still first down.
He talked about with us yesterday the fact that if Coach Landry wants him to play and about him begging not to go, he's chasing Jimmy Brown. You know, Jimmy Brown, 9 years, gained 12,312 yards. Tony's 11,715. What that computes to is he's 597 yards short of Jim Brown's record. He would like to break a record or move up in the statistics against the real professionals, the pros, the varsity, whatever you want to call them, not against replacement players.
First down and five, the pitch out to Blunt, and he has dropped behind the line of scrimmage. Loose ball, but he was downed when the ball came loose, evidently, although the whistle seemed a little late, but Byron Lee made the excellent defensive play. Second-year man from Ohio State, cut from the Eagles a year ago after being their third-round draft choice.
There you see the Cowboys now trying to run it out a little bit. Excellent job by the linebacker filling. Makes the tackle. Obviously, the ground cannot cause the fumble. That's why it was ruled that way.
Well, we've got play whistle down, and I think there's going to be a little discussion as to the last play. My only thought about it, which I expressed at the time, was that the whistle seemed to come late. I agree with your assessment of what we saw on the
ball
screen.
The ball, the ground.
Right.
Well, man was down. It'll be second down.
Right, you are. Didn't even know that they were reviewing it upon further review. Yes, well, I suspected they might be reviewing that.
Well, they're dressed Burns like replacement guys, though.
I mean, you know, there they are. Second down and a long six, and flags everywhere as Kevin Sweeney tried to get back. Cornell Burbage might have jumped a little early trying to get downfield.
It is
illegal procedure against the Cowboys. Chicago is on the board now against the Vikings. And there's another game that, as we pointed out, these games count. If the Vikings beat the Bears today, they would move into a tie with them in the Central Division. Dallas at 2-1 could move to 3-1 with a victory today, and depending on what Washington and the Giants do later here on CBS in our doubleheader action, these games count, folks, like it or not. Second and 12. Kevin Sweeney. Sideline for Edwards, and Edwards in and out of his hands, a flag down in the area of the receiver. Eagles are going to say Edwards pushed off.
No, I think so. I think it's going to be offensive pass interference. Anytime the receiver is that far open on a turn.
Pass interference, offense, number 87.
That means that he makes contact. There you'll see him come down the field, makes his move. Now, he's going to get real close to Angelo James. Right there, you just can't do that. If the arm gets away from the body, that's what the referees look for. There he just flat blows the catch. If you're going to interfere with somebody, you should at least catch the ball there. He's got a real good chance in talking to Coach Landry about being one of those players that could make his football team. He was coming here to sign and hopefully play for the Cowboys before the strike came about. Now he's given a chance to show his wares.
Two touchdowns last week.
Big guy, too.
Against the Jets. Kevin Sweeney, third down, 11. In traffic. The 10-yard line, yet another flag down, and he is tripped up in the backfield by Elo Grooms and Chuck Gorecki. 34-year-old Elo Grooms from Tennessee Tech, the New Orleans Saints. The last play of football. Penalty against the Cowboys declined. His last play in football was tackling Joe Theismann
as
a St. Louis Cardinal in 1985.
Right, he was hanging on to me in a game that really didn't count very much. I was trying to get rid of the ball. There wasn't any time left on the clock. And one of his own players came in, ran into his arm. That's the last time he played. Now he's back. Just really, he was very candid about it. He said, why are you back? He said, I'm unemployed. I'm looking for a job. I need the money. Lived down in Louisiana.
Sawyer punting from the goal line. Kevin Bowman, fair catches at the 37-yard line. And next Saturday, we'll have college football for you here on CBS. Number 14, the Nittany Lions of Penn State against number 17-ranked Syracuse. Live at 2:30 Eastern time. Some of you will be watching Nebraska, the number 2-ranked team, against Oklahoma State. So another exciting afternoon of college football ahead on CBS Sports next Saturday, 2:30 Eastern time. Cowboys taking timeout with 9:38 to go here in the first half of play. The Cowboys leading in this football game. 21. Joe Theismann here at Texas Stadium. 9:38 to go, first half, and the Cowboys, with three touchdowns in the first period, have a handy lead over the Eagles. There's
Mike Dwyer on the cover. Program, you bet. That's his autograph right there. You know, he doesn't sign it like a replacement player. See, right down there. See the player. You have to sign on your leg where it's white so people can read it. You know, you sign up here in the dark, nobody can read your name. So he's got that down pretty well.
He sure does. But he did get a big kick out of signing his autograph for Joe Theismann yesterday, folks. But he's been getting a big kick out of this entire experience of being a rhinestone cowboy and playing out there with the likes of Too Tall Jones and Randy White and Don Smirek, veteran cowboys. And he has more than held his own last week and so far this week. First down for the Eagles at the 37-yard line. Tinsley, and it's complete. Kevin Bowman. Touchdown, Eagles. Kevin Bowman from San Jose State. Free agent opportunities with Dallas and San Francisco, some time in the Canadian Football League, and now a touchdown in the National Football League for the Ersatz Eagles of Philadelphia, and they at least reduce the score here in this second period with a lot of time remaining in this football game. Philadelphia clawing their way back. Jacobs will attempt the point after. Ito Merkins will hold. He has it.
There you go. You see, actually, you see a great play by Bowman, but the guy that really makes this happen is a quarterback, Scott Tinsley. He's going to get a lot of pressure from a lot of people up the middle. He hangs in and makes an excellent throw. About the only place he could put it. Here comes the pressure from White and everybody else. He just hangs that ball up in the air. Now, Bowman does an excellent job of reaching over. He's 6'3", as we mentioned. And if you look at the defensive backs of the Dallas Cowboys, they're all little short guys. And bang, all of a sudden you get a touchdown. Now, again, you'll see the kind of pressure Tinsley's going to put on him. Leggett, Long, Walters, Perenni up front. Nice catch. Keeps his feet. You see the height difference. Now he's off to the races.
That was Jimmy Armstrong, a 5'8", 166-pounder. The man who was beaten by Bowman on the play. 62 yards, the score for the Philadelphia Eagles, Kevin Bowman. And that's the first touchdown by this replacement team of the Eagles. The semi-pros.
Still going to count as 6 points.
That's right. As Tom Landry might have referred to them yesterday. He kept talking about when the pros come back. Meeting his veteran Cowboys. Kickoff bobbled by David Adams at the 5, but Adams with a good recovery up the sideline over the 20-yard line to the 22. Driven out there by Kelly Kirchbaum, former New York Jet. He's played in the USFL and even arena football.
This is one of those knuckleballs that comes down. As you see it hit, or it hits off his hand, just squeaks away. Now, he actually could have stayed in the end zone because his momentum carried and he never had possession of the ball. Would have come out to the 20. But why? In a
not as much
game.
Fun as running
I was
out.
Just going to say, go have some fun.
Sure.
You never know what's going to happen out there.
Cowboys, first down. Sweeney with a short drop. Cornell Burbidge will be close to a first down near the 35-yard line. Victor Bellamy from Syracuse Number 39 on the coverage, made the tackle. And it will be first down, Dallas.
You know, the premium in these type of games is having your quarterback just drop back 3 yards and fire the football, 4 yards, fire the ball. That way you don't have to, you get them sacked, you don't have to ask your lineman to block long. Talk to the Eagle coaches, that's the way they want to do it. Looks like Paul Hackett and Tom Landry for the Cowboys want to approach it the same way.
Three down linemen for the Eagles in this situation, first and 10. Alvin Blunt had a hole, but then ran into a linebacker and was driven back, but a gain of 3 on the play. Matt Battaglia, rookie from Louisville, was in Cleveland's camp and a former Canadian Football League player, made the tackle.
You see the Eagles. The Eagles are in a classic 3-4. There's the down lineman. Here are your linebackers right here. And this is a little bit of an unusual formation for them. As you know, Buddy Ryan made the 4-6 popular, but it allows his linebackers and mobility on the defense, and that's really what they're keying now. They use the aggressiveness, use the mobility.
Alvin Blunt has 29 yards rushing for the Cowboys. Second and 5. And this time he is buried by a blitzing linebacker, Battaglia, and lost all of what he gained. It'll be back the original line of scrimmage in a battle for the loose football, or an attempted steal on the part of the Eagles. But no hard feelings.
They don't know each other well enough to fight yet. So, that's old.
They're just fighting for jobs.
That's all. They're concerned with that. He just absolutely strips the ball away, but you see, he's on the ground. He's on top of him, on the ground. It's a pin, and he can't have the football.
Kevin Sweeney tried to steal it right back.
Yep.
It's going to be Cowboy ball, but third down back at the original line of scrimmage.
There's Danny White. I talked to Danny yesterday. You know, that wrist of his is not completely 100%. It's never going to be. And some of the problems he's experiencing in throwing is a little bit of a sore shoulder and a little bit of a sore back because he's had to change his throwing motion so drastically.
Sweeney downfield, and it's complete to Kelvin Edwards at the 31-yard line. A flag down on the play, however, on the coverage, Angelo James. And it's going to be offensive pass interference against the Cowboys. So that will be wiped out. Edwards called for that once already. We're not sure that it's against him. We'll find out from referee Jim Tunney.
Absolutely. I think it is.
Pass interference. Offense, number 87. Penalty is 10 yards. Still third down.
So number 2 against Edwards.
There he is, matched up again. Now what happens is he takes someone out. The defensive guy can do that. But right here, you see him push his right hand into the chest of the defensive back? You can't do that. As soon as you get your arm away from your body, you're going to throw the flag. Obviously, it was inconclusive to them, so they've expressed their opinion about it.
The crowd not enjoying that call by Jim Tunney. They saw the replay on the big screen here at Texas Stadium. Third down and 20, and a quick drop and throw. It's complete out the right side to Edwards, and he gets 10 back, but it'll still be fourth down for the Cowboys. Victor Bellamy made the stop for the Eagles, so Philadelphia will get the ball back, and we have 6:52 to play still here in the first half. There you see Danny White with a little consolation for Edwards. But suddenly now, if the Eagles could do something here before halftime, we would have a much more interesting second half than it appeared we might when the Cowboys jumped on top 21-0. Buzz Sawyer will punt from the 26-yard line, and he gets a dandy away. Driving Bowman back to his 10, and he drops the ball. And it will be Eagles ball, but out of bounds, and last touch by Philadelphia Eagle player. Well, Kevin Bowman might have wanted to just let that one bounce.
Well,
he ought to get out of bounds.
There's a 10-yard rule now. He catches that right about the 10-yard line. That's okay. You should feel that. But the thing, key is you've got to catch the football. Now, what happens is look at this scramble. Now, just push the whole pile out of bounds. That's what you want to do.
54-yard punt it turns into for Sawyer.
Bruce Livingston had a shot at that thing, but it just snuck away from him.
First to the 10-yard line. Almost a 6-yard gain. Armstrong made the tackle. In comes Ciano, delivering a play, no doubt. Out comes Bowman. The Eagles can't afford to get conservative. They just have to keep doing what they've done, and that's put the football in the air. It seems to be bothering the Cowboys. Good offensive protection by the line. Now he's got to direct traffic.
Eric Daly, the tight end, lined up on the wrong side. They come back to the short side with one. Good defensive reaction by the Cowboys. Very little gain. Ed Jones was there. And the linebacker, number 51, Dale Jones.
You just don't want to run that way. I mean, it really is a mismatch. Mike Peroni over on the left side against Ed Jones, and it's
Mike Perino.
Perino.
He is from Notre Dame. You better get his name right.
I have to do that. Perino, correct.
Mike Perino.
Still doesn't change the fact he's got to block Ed Jones. He can call himself Superman.
Third down at 4. Reggie Brown drags a tackler with him, a linebacker. Number 52, Dulabon. A good effort by Jones, and he has the first down over the 15 to the 16-yard line. That was a fine effort by the second-year man from Oregon. 4:32 remaining first half. These young Eagles have got to feel that, hey, if we can get a touchdown here before halftime, we've got ourselves some more fun here in the second half. Brown has 26 yards rushing on 10 carries and some early movement. Was it on the part of the Eagles drawing the Cowboys? Looks like your guy Perino
might have been
a little eager to get ready for the assault of Jones.
Well, he's got to take that little bit of an advantage, you know, to try and get off, and that time he wasn't able to. That's what happens sometimes when you get beat by a defensive guy. That's what the lineman used to tell me anyway.
Mike Marino was a free agent with the Chargers in 86 in Tampa Bay earlier this year. 23 years of age out of Notre Dame. First and 15 now back at the 10 for the Eagles. Reggie Brown gets close to 5 back. Linebacker Russ Swan made the tackle. As we approach halftime, 3:48 to go here in the first half. A reminder that Brent and Terry Bradshaw are in our New York studio today to bring you up to date on strike news and what's going on around the league, and a special report from Will McDonough on the strike update. The last we heard, talks have broken off this Sunday afternoon. How bad it looks, well, our lads will interpret that for you at halftime. Second down and 11. Here comes Jones after Tinsley, and a flag down after the pass was thrown. Reggie Brown, the intended receiver, it appeared, the release man, fell down at the 10-yard line.
That's that screen took so long, it's probably going to be an eligible receiver downfield. Again, the linemen they do a 1-2-3 count, and then they release. And if the quarterback holds the ball longer than that, then he's going to wind up with a penalty. Cowboys are great at knocking down screen guys. I mean, they tackle the backs. If a linebacker's assigned to him, he's going to tackle and make sure he doesn't get away. There's Tunney explaining the penalty to Randy White. Now Randy looks over to the sidelines and makes his decision.
Number 75, illegally downfield, will be half the distance of the goal line and still second down.
That's Scott Leggett, the right guard from Central State, Oklahoma. And the Eagles send in a second tight end, Jay Repko, joining Eric Bailey. And out comes the running back, Alvin Ross. And the Eagles with 5 penalties, Dallas with 4 at this point. Second down at 20. So the Eagles, instead of getting upfield to try and get the points on the board, are going backwards. Brown again. Reggie Brown out to the 13. Tripped up by Dulabon. .304 and counting down first half. Dallas on top. Tim Ryan and Joe Theismann watching the Rhinestone Cowboys, giving a crowd of more than 40,000 here at Texas Stadium. Plenty to cheer about in the first period.
There's Critter-Roo again.
Well, I tell you, he's in deep trouble. He's lost his shell there.
Shell.
Yeah. We're gonna have to,
probably has to get a replacement shell.
Our producer David Winter all over that situation. Ross Tinsley takes out one tackle, gets out to the 20-yard line, but short of the first down. Dulabon and Armstrong for the Cowboys bring up a punting situation for Philadelphia.
Here's the kind of hitting you're faced with. He makes a move inside. Now he turns out. It may be replacement football, but there's some guys out there banging their heads around a little bit.
Jacob stands at his 5-yard line for the punt. Cornell Burbage is a deep man, and another short punt, but takes an Eagle bounce. Burbage at his own 40. And tripped up by the linebacker Matt Battaglia. And the Cowboys will have the football with 1:52 to play in the first half, and they lead it 21-10. Well, a solid Union Philadelphia Eagles, no veterans in, hanging in there against the Dallas Cowboys. And I think it's safe to say, Joe, that that defensive front of the Cowboys with the three veterans has definitely had an impact on the course of this game so far, because the Eagles have not been able to get any consistent offense going. They've had bad field position to start with, and apart from a couple of pass plays, they haven't been able to move it upfield.
You're right, and I think the only way they're going to be able to move it for the Philadelphia Eagles is through the air. The Cowboys have been able to run and pass.
First down, Dallas at their own 42-yard line. Play action, Kevin Sweeney. Cornell Burbage to the 35-yard line of the Eagles. You know, Kevin Sweeney, in talking to him yesterday, it's hard not to remind him of the fact that while he was cut as a seventh-round draft choice this year, they kept Paul McDonald as their third quarterback and let him go. Here he is back in the strike situation. You've got Danny White, the veteran, with a sore wrist, 35 years of age. How much is left for Danny White? You've got Scott Pelor, an unproven starter, behind him, who has yet to dazzle anybody, may turn out to be all right. You've got Paul McDonald, who I don't think anybody thinks will be an NFL starter. Kevin Sweeney could find himself back on the real roster of the Cowboys if he does well. And that won't get it done. Did I say Scott Pelor? I meant Steve Pelor. They are brothers, but the other lad is a linebacker, not a quarterback.
Well, that one was thrown like a linebacker.
That was Kevin Sweeney throwing that one,
I know.
At halftime, Brent and Terry Bradshaw with scores and highlights from around the rest of the NFL strike game activity.
You know, he probably, in all probability, would have made this football team if they had 49 players. I mean, the quarterback position is one where they like to keep three, and Kevin Sweeney just never really had a chance to play much in training camp. Matter of fact, neither did Pelor, because Danny White was coming back off of an injury, and they had to give him a lot of work and a lot of time in training camp and during the preseason.
Well, Sweeney thinks the rap against him is that he's only 6 feet tall. He says they draft those big guys nowadays. He nails that pass in there. The ball comes loose, but I believe it's going to be a completion to Sebron Spivey, number 80. Had the whistle blown when he was down or not?
No, I think that's a fumble.
Pretty good wrap on Spivey. Eagles came up with the ball, but did they get to keep it? Spivey, the injured player.
It's going to be a question. There you see Sweeney go back. He sets. Now, Spivey does an excellent job of reading the blitz. He fires the ball in the middle. Now, the question is going to be, has the ground caused him? Was he on the ground when the ball comes loose? He's hit. His knee is down, yes. His knee is down. I think they're probably going to examine it with the replay. But the fact that his knee is on the ground before the ball comes out will cause the ball to be the Cowboys' ball on the 35 or 25.
Jeff Griffin and Troy West were the two heavy hitters that popped the ball loose. And we'll see the NFL staff. Mark Burns is the replay official who will make the decision, looking at their version of the replays. They're doing that now with those monitors in front of them. They have their own videotape replays. Jim Heffernan of the NFL staff on the phone down there is communicating to the field. And again, it's a question of, I did not hear the whistle until after the play was over. But evidently it will stand as a completed pass. No infraction. No fumble on the play, pardon me. And Spivey assisted off.
See, in the last 2 minutes of the quarter, or last 2 minutes of the second quarter before the half, if you have an injury, you're automatically charged with the timeout, so they have no timeouts. It's important that the Eagles, if they do allow the Cowboys to catch a pass, to keep them inbound.
51 seconds remaining in the first half, so it's obviously critical for the Eagles to stop the Cowboys here. Having failed to score on their last possession, only 11 points down, 10 points down, they would 11 points right the first time. Tough hit on the intended receiver, Edwards, by Jeff Griffin. Griffin, who came into the Eagles camp on Thursday, an instant starter, six-year NFL veteran out of Utah.
Oh, boy, you're going to see him come down and make his move. And Jeff Griffin reads this. I played against him when he's in St. Louis. This is just pure Tattoosville. Boom! Ouch! Turn out the lights and good night.
Well, Kelvin Edwards, who had a 62-yard touchdown run on a reverse back in the first period, is going to be a little sore before he gets back into this ball game, right in the midsection. Tremendous hit by Griffin.
Jeff Griffin joined the Eagles on Thursday. It's another one of those classic situations. He joined the Eagles on, Wednesday, practiced on Thursday, practiced on Friday, and made the trip down here yesterday.
Last week we saw Anthony Allen, a similar situation for the Redskins.
Came in on Friday, right there with us. And the one thing that Buddy Ryan, I think, has impressed upon his football team is that, if nothing else, guys, I want you to be physical. And believe me, I think they're getting that message. In talking to Ted Plum, the offensive coordinator for the Eagles, before, he said, you know, we were really geared up to come down here and play the Cowboys in Texas Stadium before this whole strike came about, because we felt like we got our football team. We'd gotten our football team to a point where we really got them believing that we can go out and physically get into people, and then this whole thing came about, the strike and all. So it looks like they've impressed that same feeling to this replacement football team.
Well, they've just put the wraps on two wide receivers in a row. Spivey went to the locker room with bruised ribs for the Cowboys, and it looks like Edwards is going to be a little sore in the midsection as well. Cowboys will try the field goal. Luis Sendejas from the 34-yard line, a 44-yard attempt. For Dallas, 44-yard field goal. And that really hurts the Eagles' cause with 42 seconds left to play in the first half. 24-10 from 44 yards away. Big play in this game earlier that got the Cowboys off to a great start on their first offensive play of the game.
That's Kelvin Edwards making the turn. Now here he gets a block from Sweeney as he turns the corner and puts the Cowboys up 7-0 with very little time gone in the ballgame.
Short kickoff is gathered in by the Eagles at the 29-yard line. Topper Clemens, reserve running back number 27. And so the Eagles will have it at their 29 with 39 seconds to play.
This part of the football game, the end of the half and the end of the games, have been, I think, the most disorganized in watching the replacement football. We had a situation last week when St. Louis was in Washington, had a chance to tie. Here it's going to be a question of, can the more veteran Dallas defense shut down the opportunity for the Eagles to at least get the field goal range? Odds would say yes, but anything can happen in replacement football.
Wild play to Alvin Ross, gets out to the 35-yard line, pulled down there by number 27, Tommy Haynes. Pickup of 5 yards, maybe 6 on the play. 26 seconds remaining. Kelvin Edwards had the wind knocked out of him, we're told, and could return. Tinsley to Ross, he's got some running room. First down Eagles at the 47-yard line. Philadelphia in the hurry up and now trying to get a timeout, and they do with 9 seconds remaining. A title insurance company, and that's what he was doing when all of a sudden he got another chance to play some ball. As one of his USC teammates on the Eagles squad, safety man Troy West. Down. Hensley attacked, the ball comes loose, And it is Cowboy ball. Number 94, Randy Watts from Catawba. A rookie drafted by Kansas City this year, cut and signed by the Dallas strike team.
Now, this could be tough for the Eagles because the Cowboys are going to get one more play on their own 32-yard line. There he comes. You'll see him come around and just knock him and recover the ball. Tinsley's going to get pressure. There comes Watts. That's a misfit. Does a great job. A little bit of leapfrog. You can't put your head down when you're blocking anybody, especially when somebody's twice as big as you are.
That was Reggie Brown, the running back, trying to make that block. He's only 5'11 and 210 pounds. So Zendejas will try a 50-yard field goal to finish this first half. Field goal. Luis Zendejas may have got himself a job the way kickers are around the NFL. If you kick a 44-yarder and a 50-yarder back-to-back, you're going to get a job, but I don't think you ever saw that one go through.
I'll guarantee you never saw it.
He was flat on his face
right there.
But he knows now that it's good, and we have reached halftime.